All right, I'm on the play for round three and see if I can win despite misclicks, or maybe not. Oh, well, I have Kiki Jiki and Exarch, and I have an Archmage, but I also have Gristlebrand and Wildfire, which are just two like giant bricks. Kind of want to mulligan this hand. My standards for mulliganing are just so much higher in formats like this, where you can mulligan and still just have insane hands. So one lander. All right, I'm gonna keep this hand. This hand's not great, but I mean, what are the odds that this hand goes right compared to the hand that was just two land Exarch and cards that cost 4 and 5 mana? So we'll see what ends up happening. My opponent just said they expected Storm because they've watched previous videos, which is just kind of what I was going for. And my opponent said they faced Storm round one, so I suppose that would explain why I am not Storm. I'm really hoping to draw a Signet here. A black Signet would be insane if I drew like Dimir Rakdos Signet. Mox Diamond would also be quite good. Mox Emerald or Mox Ruby would also be quite good. Basically, anything that lets me cast Gifts on turn three. Come on, Signet. That's not a Signet. Kiki Jiki is not great to draw here. I mean, yes, I can Gifts for now Exarch, but fairly far away from being able to cast Kiki Jiki. Corsair, I'm just gonna find my opponent's playing a Gilded Lotus. That would be insane. No. Turn two Corsair off Wall of Roots and Mox. Pretty nice, and my opponent's gonna be able to play Gilded Lotus next turn if they've got another land. Elves, jeez, my opponent's deck looks pretty good. Come on, Mox. Rakdos Signet now? Why have you betrayed me? Alright, I guess I have Gifts later. Though that does add the second red, which means that I may be in a spot where I could play Gifts and be more confident that I'll cast Kiki Jiki. Mystical Leader's no good, because I'd kind of resigned myself to the fact that my opponent has near infinite mana, but was hoping they wouldn't have anything insane to play. I guess they get to play Gilded Lotus this turn, and the next turn draw Mystical. So if I can draw another red source and cast nice little Gifts, then I might be in okay shape. End of combat. I think my opponent means to do this during their main phase. That would be my suspicion. All right. Can they not take back the Wall of Roots? But it's a mana ability. Well, they're trying to figure that out right now. All right, it's my turn, and I drew a mountain. My opponent, basically, what happened there is they added mana during combat to play Gilded Lotus, which obviously you can't do during combat. Tried to undo it all, wasn't able to undo Wall of Roots, so instead just passed and did nothing. So there we go. That's unfortunate for my opponent, that's for sure. Though, if they were going to just cast Mystical this turn, it's not that bad. But if they were planning on doing something with that Gilded Lotus, that could be pretty unfortunate. Alright, so their hand right now is Gilded Lotus and Mystical Tutor. I'm going to Gifts end of turn. I think I'll Gifts with the Black Floating because I'll get a Vampiric Tutor. And let's see. I guess I'm not going to have enough mana to go off with Kiki Jiki on my turn here. Which is unfortunate. This is Gilded Lotus. Probably just gonna let it resolve because I'm gonna cast Gifts, but I'm not gonna worry about having my doing it in response, because if my opponent has a counterspell, then almost anything I do here is not gonna be great. So I'm certainly getting Vampiric Tutor. The question is, what else do I want to get? Well, let's see here. I'm choosing my opponent. Gifts ungiven. I could get Vamp, Pestermite, no, Vamp Deceiver, because I guess Deceiver is a little tougher. Vamp Deceiver, ooh, Wildfire. Actually, Wildfire kills everything but leaves a Gilded Lotus in play. That's somewhat suspicious. I could get Sneak Attack, because I don't think I'm going to be given Sneak Attack. Sneak Attack, Vamp, Deceiver, and I could get Glenelandra Archmage. I could get Duretti, or I could get Deceiver, Pestermite, Vamp, and Gristlebrand. And if I get any of the Pestermite or Deceiver, that's decent. And if I get Vamp, I can get Sneak Attack and go with Gristlebrand. So yeah, that actually seems reasonable. So let's get Gristlebrand. Deceiver, Exarch, Pestermite, Empiric Tutor. And I guess hope to draw a Mox to go off with the Pestermite or Deceiver. I just don't think I'm going to get Pestermite or Deceiver, which is why I didn't want to include a Mox in there. Though we will see. We will see what my opponent decides here. It would be nice to get Vamp Gristlebrand. That one seems like it's going to be kind of tough. Thing is, if I get like Deceiver, Pestermite, or Deceiver, or I guess Pestermite, Gristlebrand is maybe more likely. If I draw a Mox, I can just win. If I don't, I can still just Pestermite my opponent's like Gildotus. Alright, I like that. This is what I was hoping to get. I think this is the one that is most likely to win me the game. Vamp for Sneak Attack. Draw. Land. Play Sneak Attack. Sneak Attack in Gristlebrand. Let's draw 7 now so I can maybe sneak and attack with something else. Looking for Woodfall Primus. Sphinx of the Steel Wind. Well, I still might have a shot at Woodfall Primus here, so I'm going to... Actually, I don't have quite enough. Because what I can do is I can sneak in Kiki Jiki as well. But I don't need to... I think I'd rather attack for 13, gain 13 life, and then draw more cards to hit Woodfall Primus and Kiki Jiki the Woodfall Primus. Yeah, this is going awesome. Look at this. I mold a bunch and... this is the game where I mold to like 3 or something? Is that correct? Alright. First strike. Post-combat now. I'm gonna have to take a couple more shots here. And again, I'll stop, I think, once I hit Woodfall Primus. Because now I get to go land. Or rather, Mox. Land. I know where to put a land. Mox Diamond. Discard a mountain. Sneak Attack in Woodfall Primus. And this can destroy a non-creature permanent. Okay, I was going to see if it could destroy enchantments and destroy Courser, but I guess that is not accurate. Kill Gilded Lotus. And then I think I put in Kiki Jiki here, because that lets me kill another thing. I guess my opponent has to Mystical. I'll see what my opponent Mystical's for. My opponent said that was their one chance. Yeah. The thing I like about getting Deceiver, Exarch, and Pestermite and Gifts there is this: there people are so afraid of them. Obviously, I could even not have the Kiki Jiki, though my opponent, I don't think, wanted to bank on that. Having Mox Ruby and Mox Diamond in your deck when you have Sneak Attack and Grizzlebrain is pretty nice, got to admit. All right, let's see what Mystical gets. Upheaval. Upheaval's probably not happening. And probably not even going to be that good against me. So do I want a Kiki Jiki... the Woodfall Primus. It just basically, I lose Kiki Jiki, but in exchange get an extra trigger. I don't think I need to do it. I think I can just pass, because I'm already getting an extra one off the Woodfall Primus itself dying. I could have also kept the mana on tap, not use Woodfall Primus, and then have Glenelg Archmage up. Opponent's, of course, just conceding now, so that worked out. Yeah, that was a pretty sweet game here, given that, let's see, did I not, yeah, mulligan to 3, or no, 4? No, I guess 5. Oh, it was the other game that I mulliganed to 3. I mulliganed to 5, but my 5 land hand wasn't good, but Gifts is a pretty powerful card in this deck. Against green ramp with upheaval, I guess Memory Lapse is probably decent. I could just take out the Murderous Cut because I don't care about, like, large green creatures just do not bother me. I don't think I'm going to lose to them very easily, though. I guess Pelucranus Sarai's Wildfire, which is kind of annoying. But, yeah, Memory Lapse seems fine.